Welcome to Proteal's production channel. Do you wanna subscribe to my channel before traveling the climax of knowledge again today? Don't forget to click on the bell. Welcome dude, let's start. Diabetes mellitus was one of the first diseases described, with an Egyptian manuscript from 1500 BCE mentioning two great emptying of the urine. Indian physicians around the same time identified the disease and classified it as madameha or honey urine, noting the urine would attract ants. The word diabetes comes from Latin diabetes, which in turn comes from ancient Greek, which literally means siphon. The word mellitus comes from the classical Latin word sweet. Its effective treatment was found exactly 4,000 years after it was first discovered. The early part of the 20th century when Canadian Frederick Banting isolated and purified insulin in 1922. However, as is known, this treatment only ensures that patients can survive. There is still no definitive treatment. In 2017, 425 million people had diabetes worldwide, up from an estimated 108 million people in 1980. Accounting for the shifting age structure of the global population, the prevalence of diabetes is 8.8% among adults, nearly double the rate of 4.7% in 1980. That means diabetes is growing faster than cancer. This is an incredible increase. The WHO estimates that diabetes resulted in 4.5 million deaths in 2017, making it the eighth leading cause of death. There are two types of diabetes and constantly confused. Type 1 diabetes results from the pancreas's failure to produce enough insulin due to loss of beta cells. This form was previously referred to as insulin-dependent diabetes mellitus or juvenile diabetes. The loss of beta cells is caused by an autoimmune response. The cause of this autoimmune response is unknown. Some research says that the cause is severe diseases that occur when they are young. It develops suddenly in childhood. There is no stage with this disease. Once diagnosed, you are lifelong insulin dependent. Quality of life is determined by regular follow-up of sugar, sports activities and nutrition. These patients become thin, unlike type 2. These patients take insulin 3 or 4 times, depending on their diet. It is mostly taken with a needle. Insulin pumps are still a developing technology. Only 10% of all diabetes cases are type 1. If a child you know has weakness, frequent drinking and urination for unknown reasons, we recommend that you contact a healthcare provider. With the developing drugs, they can easily sustain their lives. Let's get to 90% of it, type 2 diabetes. This form was previously referred to as non-insulin-dependent diabetes mellitus or adult-onset diabetes. The most common cause is a combination of excessive body weight and insufficient exercise. Type 2 diabetes is characterized by insulin resistance, which may be combined with relatively reduced insulin secretion. The defective responsiveness of body tissues to insulin is believed to involve the insulin receptor. However, the specific defects are not known. Many people with type 2 diabetes have evidence of prediabetes, impaired fasting glucose and/or impaired glucose tolerance before meeting the criteria for diabetes. The progression of prediabetes to overt type 2 diabetes can be slowed or reversed by lifestyle changes or medications that improve insulin sensitivity or reduce the liver's glucose production. Diabetes is primarily due to lifestyle factors and genetics. A number of lifestyle factors are known to be important to the development of type 2 diabetes, including obesity, defined by a body mass index of greater than 30, lack of physical activity, poor diet, stress, and urbanization. Dietary factors such as sugar-sweetened drinks is associated with an increased risk. The type of fats in the diet is also important, with saturated fat and trans fats increasing the risk and polyunsaturated and monounsaturated fat decreasing the risk. Eating lots of white rice also may increase the risk of diabetes. A lack of physical activity is believed to cause 7% of cases. Substitution other whole grains or brown for white rice may lower the risk of diabetes, although results are mixed. Adverse childhood experiences, including abuse, neglect, and household difficulties, increase the likelihood of type 2 diabetes later in life by 32%, with neglect having the strongest effect. Basically, if you are an individual with a type 2 diabetes predisposition, every sugary food you eat brings you one step closer to the sad end. Also, playing sports will change the course of this disease. Patients usually start with pills. However, every patient who does not pay attention to his lifestyle finally starts using needles. Gestational diabetes is the third main form and occurs when pregnant women without a previous history of diabetes develop high blood sugar levels. Most likely, it passes after childbirth. Very rarely, a lifetime can leave a lasting illness in the mother. In these cases, it is best to keep in touch with doctors frequently. Finally, let's look at the damage that uncontrolled diabetes will cause to the body. The primary complications of diabetes due to damage in small blood vessels include damage to the eyes, kidneys, and nerves. Damage to the eyes, known as diabetic retinopathy, is caused by damage to the blood vessels in the retina of the eye and can result in gradual vision loss and eventual blindness. Damage to the kidneys, known as diabetic nephropathy, can lead to tissue scarring, urine protein loss, and eventually chronic kidney disease, sometimes requiring dialysis or kidney transplantation. Damage to the nerves of the body, known as diabetic neuropathy, is the most common complication of diabetes. The symptoms can include numbness, tingling, pain, and altered pain sensation, which can lead to damage to the skin. Diabetes-related foot problems, such as diabetic foot ulcers, may occur and can be difficult to treat, occasionally requiring amputation. If you have a diabetic person you know, please do not recommend sugar to him. Reduce your sugar consumption for the health of yourself and your loved ones. We hope that the developing technology will find the cure for this disease. Until then, take care. My next video will be an introduction to philosophy. What is the truth? Can we find the truth, or is it innate? Stay on track. The sources of all the information said in this video are given in the description section. Please comment to make corrections or additions. If you still have not subscribed, you can subscribe and like the video. Take care yourself. Ciao, ciao.